taxation for technology startups. When an organization, especially when a technology startup, starts to earn the income, the government imposes some of the tax schemes that needs to be taken into consideration. This video will provide the useful information related to preliminary matters, tax registration, income tax, sales tax, professional tax, advance tax, minimum tax, tax exemptions, tax returns, bookkeeping and record keeping, tax audit, and caveats and watchouts. Before explaining all of these important aspects of the taxes, some of the important and commonly used terms are financial year or tax year. Normal tax year is the year ending 30th June. Special tax year is year other than a normal tax year approved by the tax authorities, usually ending 31st December. Some of the important terminologies in taxation which you can see are on the screen. FBR, Federal Board of Revenue, PRA, Punjab Revenue Authority, ITO 2001, Income Tax Ordinance 2001, Under Section, NTN, National Tax Number, WHT, Withholding Tax, Turnover, Total Revenue or Sales, Zero Rated, Goods or services that are taxable for sales tax or value-added tax, but with a tax rate of zero. Let's explain some of the terminologies, such as exempt, goods or services that are altogether exempted from tax. Tax credit, amount of money that taxpayers can subtract from taxes owed to tax authorities. Unlike deductions and exemptions which reduce the amount of taxable income, tax credits reduce the actual amount of tax owed. Rebate or refund. Refund by tax authorities to a taxpayer who has paid more tax than they owed. There are around four types of tax applied by four different agencies that can be seen on the screen. When it comes to tax subjects, it includes salaried persons, business individuals, associations of persons, companies consisting of small companies, private and public companies, and banking companies. Registration of the tax includes steps. First, income tax or national tax number registration is compulsory for anyone with a taxable income and companies. Second, sales tax registration is compulsory for anyone engaged in the sale of goods. Sales tax on services registration is compulsory for anyone engaged in the sale of taxable services. NTN registration is a prerequisite for sales tax registration. Let's move on to income tax. Income tax is a direct tax, that is, it is levied directly on the taxpayer's income. Income tax is a progressive tax, that is, the higher the income, the higher the tax is going to be. Income tax is levied on profits, that is, revenue minus expenses, subject to some exceptions. Income tax on salaried persons is levied on salary. Income tax is a withholding tax, that is, it is wholly or partially withheld or deducted at source by the payer at the time of payment. Payer acts as tax authority's withholding and collecting agent for the WHT part of income tax. Withholding tax aspect of income tax is presumptive and adjustable against payee's final income tax liability. When it comes to the calculation of the income tax, on the screen you can see the breakdown stepwise, from monthly salary to annual and rate of tax that can be applied. Let's move on to sales tax. Sales tax is a fixed tax. Sales tax is an indirect tax, that is, it is levied indirectly on the taxpayer or payee on purchase of goods and services. Sales tax is levied on sales, that is, goods and services at the time of the sale. Sales tax rate depends upon the types of goods and services being sold. Sales tax is primarily not a withholding tax, there being a few exceptions, of course. Unlike income tax, sales tax is non-presumptive. When it comes to the current rate of sales tax in Punjab, it is 17% on goods and 16% on the services. Of course, terms and conditions applied. After sales tax comes professional tax. Professional tax is levied on and collected from persons or class of persons engaged in a profession, trade, calling, or employment in Punjab province. Professional tax is a direct tax, that is, levied directly on the taxpayer, an annual tax, that is, levied annually, a progressive tax, that is, levied according to size of business. Bigger the business size, higher the tax. And a nominal tax, that is, it is not a heavy tax. Another important part of tax is advance tax, which is a presumptive tax, that is, levied on presumed income. Advance tax is payable by individuals, association of persons, and companies. It is payable quarterly, that is, every 3 months. Advance tax is adjustable as a tax credit against tax liability for the tax year in which advance tax has been paid. Advance tax is not applicable on royalty fee or fee for technical services to non-residents under Section 6 of the Income Tax Ordinance 2001. Also, it is applicable on taxes on shipping and air transport income under Section 7 of the Income Tax Ordinance 2001, subject to certain exceptions. There is a calculation formula for the advance tax that includes taxpayer's turnover for the quarter, the tax assessed to the taxpayer for the latest tax year, the taxpayer's turnover for the latest tax year, the tax paid in quarter for which a tax credit is allowed under Section 168. Whereas it is for the companies, but when it comes to individuals, it only includes taxpayers' latest tax and the tax paid in the quarter for which a tax credit is allowed under Section 168, other than tax deducted under Section 149. Minimum tax, which is liable to be paid by any business with an annual turnover of Rs. 10 million. Minimum tax is applicable even where a business suffers losses or the tax yield on income is less than 1.25% of turnover. Minimum tax is adjustable against a business's tax liability for subsequent 5 years. Government has introduced the tax exemptions for startups. Startups are exempted from payment of income tax for a period of 3 years from their commencement. And those are being an information technology entity engaged in offering technology-driven products or services to any sector of the economy, and having an annual turnover of up to Rs. 100 million, and registered and certified by the Pakistan Software Export Board. When it comes to IT exports, tax is also exempted on IT services such as software development, software maintenance, system integration, web design, web development, web hosting, and network design. Another factor is IT-enabled services, which include inbound or outbound call centers, medical transcription, remote monitoring, graphic design, accounting services, HR services, telemedicine centers. Data entry operations locally produced television programs and insurance claims processing. When it comes to tax returns, there are different deadlines for different entities. August 31st for salaried persons, salary only. September 30th for salaried persons, other income. September 30th for business individuals and AOPs. And December 31st every year for companies. It is important to all entities to cover the bookkeeping and record keeping on the income. It must include bank statement, account book, profit and loss account, and expenses. The major part in the tax is the tax audit. You can be subjected to a tax audit in any year by FBR or PRA through either random audit selection or parametric audit selection. In a tax audit, your self-assessed annual income tax return will be subjected to audit, which may result in you being found liable to pay additional tax. Tax compliance and good bookkeeping and record keeping are keys to successfully surviving a tax audit. It is important for all the entities to consult a tax consultant, that is, an accountant, a chartered accountant, or a specialist tax lawyer. Final accounts should be prepared by a professional accountant. Tax returns should be filed through a tax agent or accountant. Appreciate the difference between tax avoidance or evasion and tax minimization. The former is illegal, the latter is not. If anything, tax minimization should be an objective.